I tried planning my day with an AI chatbot. So I connected my chatbot up inside of AkiFlow, which is a popular to-do list application. And I wanted to see whether you can use a to-do list app to organize your tasks without even touching your planner and actually use it to chat with it. And there were some good results and some bad results. One I'll cover in this video. So I was in a coffee shop and I decided it's time to plan my day. I wanted to try this test out for real. So I literally trying to organize every aspect of tomorrow and also this evening. So I essentially asked the chatbot to book a time slot for the evening with some administrative work. And it was able to create a simple time slot that helped me to start organizing what I had for the evening. So I was off to a fairly good start. Then I decided, okay, on Wednesday, I want to book a boxing and sauna session. So it connects with Google Calendar and I can essentially ask it something like, okay, create a Google Calendar event for this time with this title. And I can also prompt it to change it as well if I made a mistake. So I did that and it created the event for me. Now, when I was interacting with the Todoist task, it was a little bit more flaky. So I wanted to move certain Todoist tasks into the day. It was able to do it with one, but struggled and was extremely slow with all of the others. I checked what Wi-Fi was on in this coffee shop, which is fairly good. And it was between 65 and 75 for the majority of the time, but actually on an average of 61. So there was no excuse for the internet being slow. So I think there may have been a AI-based area with the API. However, I was able to start blocking some in, although it wasn't as accurate, blocking in some of the admin tasks that it automatically associated to the evening, which was a little bit of a pain. Now, in terms of actually booking events, I was able to do it really quite easily, actually. I actually booked a meeting with my co-founder and we were able to do it, or I was able to do it for him quite easily, but it wasn't able to recommend any slots, which was something that was a little bit of pain. Now, I was able to do multi actions with this. So for example, I said, could you book 3 tasks tomorrow? And can you add a task at 10 a.m., a task at 11 a.m., and a task at 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. and allocate it to a certain project? And it did it all really well, but it was slightly slow on uptick. So I could have just been testing it at a really slow time for the API to be working, but at the same time, something to be aware of if you're trying this out. Did you know that over 1.3 million people use Zapier with AI? This can help you save time, optimize repetitive tasks, and get more done. Zapier helps you to create workflows and automation by building simple or complex workflows and connecting nearly 8,000 integrations. Zapier is one of the leaders in AI automation, and that's why over 3.4 million companies use Zapier to get things done. Get started today for free down in the link in the description. Now, one of the things that you are still able to do is communicate with this in a more relaxed manner. They have something called workflows, which allows you to set a workflow. For example, the AkiFlow chatbot can essentially ping you when the weather is good so that you can set your day up quite well. And they're actually working on a few more features outside of this. For example, they're going to be working on a feature that is a proactive planner and not just reactive, which is pretty helpful. So a very interesting one at that. So here are the things that I loved about this and the things that I hated. It worked really well for basic tasks that were built inside of AkiFlow. I was able to book a time slot and be able to organize that. So you could, for example, start diatribing or using the voice recording to essentially plot your entire day, which is quite helpful. The things that I didn't like were particularly that it was trapped inside the chat window on the right-hand side. The output felt messy as well. It didn't sort of feel like a ream of text coming back at you. And also I didn't like how the speed worked. I can imagine if you're somebody that was a little bit more less patient than me, you would probably find this a little bit painful and sluggish. And the Todoist integration didn't work very well in case, unless you use the exact title name, which was a bit of a pain. But I did find that the sync worked between devices fairly well. When I checked my iOS device, it did sync nicely. So what are my opinions on using this chatbot for future task management? Now, I was able to actually chat with the founder and talk through some of the more proactive planner abilities. And he actually tested on the phone this feature that actually handled a call with me that he prompted his chatbot to send automatically. And it worked really seamlessly. So I'm looking forward to those type of elements that work with email, text, and conversation. Now, it supports over 3,000 integrations. So unlike other applications like Motion and I think Sensama does have have integrations like this, but that's a real bonus when it comes to getting things kicked off. Now, Zapier is one of them and they are today's sponsor. So thanks to Zapier for sponsoring this video. You can find them linked below if you're interested. But Anki Flow, an interesting one with an interesting AI bolted on. So you can find it linked below if you're interested. If you want to explore more tools, jump over to toolfinder.co and I'll check out more with you soon.